beautiful from the very moment you arrived. I felt something new inside.
Hello. I mean, good morning. Okay. I just came over here for a quick little, it's gonna be real quick. I'm making chitterlings and hog maws for dinner today. So, I boiled my water first. I do a whole onion, but I cut it in half. So, everybody don't eat chitterlings and everybody don't eat hog maws. But if you do eat them, if you eat them, you love them. So, a lot of people is not gonna like this video. A lot of people is gonna be talking shit. Ew, did she? Ew, she eat that next shit? That shit stank. It do. It do stink, but it's good. But I'm gonna tell y'all what I buy. I'm gonna show you what I buy. For the people that love them, I buy Aunt Bessie's. I buy Aunt Bessie's. They already clean. You don't have to clean them. I promise you don't have to do nothing with them. I always throw them out. And I ain't got no corona. I smoke cigarettes. Folks, somebody say something about that. And I smoke a lot of cigarettes. So that's why I got a cough. But anywho, they already clean. So you defrost them. You know, you throw them out. And always, I got cutting scissors that, you know, that I cook with. I always cut them. Cut them to the size I want. And I don't do a lot of cutting because you can cut them once they get on your plate. But I cut them, you know, down so they don't be like big pieces of chitlin. And then I'ma show you in a minute what they look like. But anyhow, you put an onion, a whole onion, cut it in half. Lemon juice. I put lemon juice in my chitlins because this really helps cut down on the smell. The lemon juice helped cut out the smell. And I use apple cider vinegar. And the trick behind the apple cider vinegar is because that's pork. Anybody that eat chitlins, anybody that know anything about pork, know chitlins is the hog's intestines. So, I mean, I don't know what the fucking difference is. We eat all of it, all the shit nasty. Once you clean it and you cook it, it's good. But some people won't eat that part of the hog. Anyhow, I put the vinegar in there because, you know, pork sometimes make your blood pressure go up. I found that if you cook with vinegar, it kind of keep your, you know, keep that pork from fucking with your blood pressure. So, a whole onion cut in half. I'm going to squeeze some lemon juice in this water and cut it in half. And I only just cut it in half. And I'm just gonna squeeze that lemon juice in this water. That's gonna cut down on the smell. I don't know what it really do for the flavor. I mean, it might make it taste better, I don't know, but I use it for to cut down on that smell because they stink so bad. And so I'm gonna bring y'all some. I'm just gonna put some inside something so y'all can see what it look like. I've already rinsed them. Like I said, you don't have to clean these. Just rinse them real good, you know, and kind of let them sit in the water and just make sure they're clean. Let me show you what it looked like. This is what they look like when you get them out of the water. when you wash them, you know, you still gotta wash them, but look, they clean. They ain't got no fat, they ain't got no corn in them, they ain't got no sticks and nothing in them. They, you know, they everything is, they clean them already, okay? But it's a trick to this. It's a trick. It's a trick to this. Let me wash my hands. Okay. The trick to this is, these chitlins, they not cheap. These chitlins end up costing probably, I want to say I paid $18 for a bag. It was like $17.65, about two bags. Now, that's $40 for some damn chitlins. So, motherfuckers, talk about these chitlins. These chitlins ain't cheap. We pay for these damn things. So, don't think they the poor man meal, because motherfuckers damn sure ain't cheap. They very expensive, and if you gonna buy them already clean like this, you gonna pay about $20 a bag. And in that $20 a bag, I don't know how many pounds. I have to look and see. Okay, you get 5 pounds. You get 5 pounds, but that's really good, because I remember back in the day, because we growed up on cooking chitlins, and my mama made us clean them motherfuckers. We had to clean them, me and my sister. So we would clean them, whole house be stinking like hell. But we would clean them, and you know, you might get a 5 pound bucket, you might come out with a quarter of a pound of chitlins. It was all fat, cause you, all that shit that was in the chitlins put weight on them. So it made the shit, the bucket, weigh more. So 5 pound chitlins, shit, you gotta get 2-3 buckets. You know, it was just three of us. I was the greedy one in the house. Everybody else would eat like birds. So that shit pissed me off. And I vowed when I got grown and get my church, have my church start buying groceries, I was gonna buy me some motherfucking groceries and I'm gonna eat. So anywho, y'all see the chitlins. Now this ain't all of them. I'm just showing y'all. Oh, shit. I'm just showing y'all what it looked like. I just want to show y'all, you know, show y'all again what it looked like before I start dropping them. So I just go ahead and start dropping them. Cause I don't season all it till I get them all in the pot. Even a cheap ass pan. So I'm dropping the rest of these chitlins. Now I also have hot dogs. Pretty much everybody that likes chitlins gonna want some. They gonna eat hot dogs. If they eat chitlins, they eat hot dogs. So let me get them, and then I can show you how I do this. So what I do. And these are the hot dogs. Everybody that, these are the hot dogs, y'all. So Food Depot had these for little or nothing. All I do is just open them and drop them in the sun like I do the chitlins and clean them like that, same way. Only thing about the hot dogs is, you don't have to pull no fat or nothing like that. They already be pretty much clean, but you gotta make sure you get all that extra gristle and stuff off of them. So I just put them in a sink full of water too. Y'all, my video's taking forever to upload on YouTube. I don't don't really know how to do it. Really, my son is the one that really know how to do it. So I'm really happy him do it, and he don't live with me. So don't call me talking about give me some of them chitlins and them hot mall, because by the time you get this video, these motherfuckers, they gone, because it's probably about 3 or 4 days later. So hold on one second. Okay, y'all. And what I would do, because my hot moss is cleaning. I'm gonna tell you what I put in here as far as the seasoning, and then we're gonna add hot moss. And then I'm gonna let y'all go, because they cook for like 3 hours. All this shit cook for 3 hours. So that's another thing. You know, some people may not want to deal with the cooking of these things. Let me tell y'all something. A lot of folks don't want to cook them because they stink. Okay. Honestly, the way I do them, they really don't smell that bad cooking. But if somebody want me to cook them some chitlins, I'm laying up right now. It's not a whole lot of work to do it. You go buy your chitlins. I get them from C&J's. You can get it from the C&J's over there by on the east side. The one I got mine from the one off of Joy Cliff Road in Millerfield. Now, if you want to go get you a bag or two, or the other C&J might have it too. The one over there by Geico, they might have it too. But now, if you want to get you a bag or two, or you want me to cook you some chitlins, I don't mind cooking them. I'm going to charge your ass though. I'm gonna charge you. I don't give a damn if you did buy them yourself and you spent $18 a bag. I'm gonna charge you. I'm gonna charge you to cook them now. I ain't gonna hit you on the head, but I'm gonna charge you. Then my recipe, I'm gonna have to charge you. Okay. So. Okay, y'all. Okay, y'all. So. You're gonna put pepper. Y'all know I keep this on deck. I use this for everything. You're gonna put pepper. Okay, whatever kind of pepper you want, it's on, whatever you buy. Season salt. You gotta put that old black, this old black seasoning here. You know, we grew up out there. You gotta put the season salt in there. And y'all know how I feel about measuring. So, lemon pepper. Y'all know how I feel about measuring. I'm not measuring anything now. So, you gotta put your shit in there for your taste. Leave all your seasonings out, because at the end of your cooking, you're going to have to taste these things when they're halfway done. And you need to make sure that you got everything in here. Now, this Slap Your Mama, it's a Cajun seasoning. I buy it from Food Depot. It's really good, and it's spicy. Y'all know I like spicy shit. It's spicy. So I like my chitlins and my hot moss a little bit spicy. Okay? So you got that. Garlic salt. This is a new one. I know that. I pretty much use garlic salt on everything. The only reason why I'm using 2 salts, I usually use like 1 salt if I'm gonna use 1 salt. But because, see, this pan is so big, the water is up to here. So you wanna make sure everything's seasoned enough. So a little garlic salt on top of the Cajun seasoning and on top of the seasoned salt, it's okay. Because you got so much to season in here, and the water so full. Oh, onion powder. I use onion powder. Even though you got an onion in there, I still use onion powder for the flavor. And I always seem to forget this lately. Garlic powder. So you got garlic powder, onion powder, you got the Slap Your Mama seasoning, you got your lemon pepper, perfect pinch, you got seasoned salt, you got your pepper, the regular pepper, and you got your garlic salt. Okay, remember, a half a lemon juice squeezed in there and a whole onion cut in half. Okay, I don't know if I sprinkled this shit in here already or not. I'm getting old, my mind bad, but I'm gonna put some more in here. Garlic powder, okay? Now, I'm gonna go ahead and cut these hot moss up and put them in here. Now, I've already showed you what it looked like, so I'm gonna try to show you what it looked like before I put them with this. Hold on. I'm gonna put a few inside something. That's going on. I'm gonna show y'all what they look like, and that way, you know, I know people probably think some of us are crazy, that they think all the pig should not be eaten. But let me tell y'all something. For the people who don't know, and most, I ain't trying to be funny, most black people know where these stem from, okay? And I'm keeping it real right now. The reason why black people love this kind of shit, I ain't saying all black people, but a lot of black people love this, is because, you know, this is our heritage. Like, when back in the slavery days, we didn't get to eat pork chops, bacon. We didn't get to eat that bullshit. No, you got the damn pig's hoofs. Uh-huh. That's what they gave us to eat out in the field. Uh-huh. You got the goddamn pig's guts. That's the chitterlings. Okay, you got the pig's head. You know, you got the pig's tail. That's what we ate. So don't be, ew, they nasty. Nah, motherfucker. I'm not racist by any means, but what I'm saying is, I hate it when the other races, I ain't gonna just say one race, other races say, ugh, they so nasty to eat that. Bitch, y'all gave it to us. If we didn't eat the shit, we were gonna starve to death. Shit. So, anywho, but we appreciate that. We appreciate it, because guess what, baby? I can live off this shit here. Damn sure can, because we were taught to live off of it. We didn't have no choice. Now we got a choice. It's just something that we love. Because that's our heritage. Shit, that's all we had. Okay? So, don't be on here talking, black folks eat that shit. Don't say black folk, because I'll get in your ass. You know why black folks eat it? Because we were forced to eat it. And if we didn't eat it, we starved to the fucking death. All right? Now, anywho, let me show y'all these goddamn hog maws. Well, I done got my blood pressure up in here now. Okay. See? These are the hog maw. Y'all know what? I don't know what the fuck a hog maw is. I ain't gonna tell you no lie. It come out the pig. I'm looking at the shit. I don't know. If somebody know, please let me know. Tell me. I don't know. I haven't researched the shit. I just like them. I know they're part of the pig. They don't smell. They don't stink like the chitlins. They really don't. And they really, really, really are good. So they gotta be something on the inside of the hog, but I just don't know where the part inside of the hog, if it's a part of the stomach. This is the intestine. Maybe this is the stomach. I don't know. Somebody please let me know if you do. But anyhow, I'm going to end this video, and then we're going to come back. I'm going to come back and show y'all in 3 hours, once everything is done, what it look like. And once we mix them together, and once I make a plate, okay? Have a good one. Thanks. Okay, y'all. This is the finishing product of the chitlins from the earlier video. I almost forgot to come back and show y'all what they look like afterwards. So this is a, I just put some in a little small bowl. And again, they got hot sauce on them. They got parsley flakes on them. And if you saw the whole video, I walked you through the whole process of cooking them. I said they would probably end up taking about 3 hours. They end up taking 4 hours. I guess because it was so many I had in the pan, and y'all know how big the pan was. So it was like that pan was full in the beginning, and at the end, they cooked all the way down to like less than half of the pan. So they always cook down after when they're done. So you have to buy a lot of them so you can feed a lot of people if you're going to have a big party or something. But if it's your family, you can always like do the 2 5-pound. I had 2 5-pound Aunt Bessie, I think it's like Aunt Bessie's, chitlins, and I had 2 packs of just regular size packs of hog maws that we put together. And again, please like, share, and subscribe, and hit the notification bell if you would. Thank y'all. Sometimes I